So, hey guys, Chauzu here. So I thought I'd start with something special, this treasure map, because everybody are up in arms about this ISO intrusion, and I'm not going to lie, it's not the greatest design. The main problem is the booster list, and as I think you famously know by now, the fact that stage 3 gives 7 turns of special bind, along with other stuff like 50k death damage together with 5 turns of increased damage taken times 10, which equals to 500,000 damage. But yeah, I do have some good news at least, and it's that I am bringing you some teams you can build, and I guarantee you that you'll be able to find at least one team you can use for this treasure map that will do decent damage. I'm hoping it will last for 15 ad levels. But yeah, this is designed for all the new batch, of course, but we're only using Whitey Bay. For this particular team, we use Ray-Ban, Friend Captain, and for the other teams I'll show you, it will be Whitey Bay Friend to try and maximize points. But yeah, this content boosts Free Spirit, Powerhouse, and Striker. Very frustrating, if I might add, if they just had a Cerebral or Driven, it would have been so good. Now we got a bit scuffed because of that, but it is what it is. Second stage, end of turn HP cut, which could be annoying, not going to lie. 5 turns bind, 4 turns the spear, 3 turns paralysis, and slots to block. And when defeated, heals to full. Second stage, full immunity, 5 turns resilience, 5 turns Raybon shield. A very annoying damage barrier is like 10 million, I think it is. 7 turns special bind, and you need to be about 2.5 times chain, or you get a 90% attack down, and of course that increased damage taken. And you're not allowed to use certain chain boost. Not chain boundary for sure. The second one sounds like increasing the rate, so either chain multiplier or increased chain rate. Like, we don't really have a good name for that. It's the mechanic from, say, the Kid and Law Legends from last year, where each tap you do higher chain, basically. So, let's get into it anyway. So yeah, this first team uses Ray-Ban Friend Captain. I need to double check for every team that I account for the increased damage taken. We need to remove 5 turns, which we do with this team. Cat and Dog should also remove 3. Yes. And that's one of the only reasons we use Cat and Dog. The other one is to swap to remove Paralysis. So basically with this team, stage 2, you use Roger's super type, get full bar of matching orbs. We use... I realize now that we're using Odin's, we don't need to swap, so... yeah, don't really need to swap, but... I still picked in an Echo since that increased damage taken removal and high booster, so it's fine, in my opinion, to keep them. But yeah, we use Roger, and we're hoping that... basically, we use Odin Special first, remove the remaining paralysis. Rayleigh Special will remove most of the paralysis, as well as the bind and the spear. Then after using Odin with Buggy to get attack boost, we can use Roger Special to get 3 turns of color affinity. And that means we have color affinity and attack boost on Odin, so hopefully Odin will be able to do enough damage stage 2. We don't really know the color for sure. I think it will be Dex, but you can't rule out it being Int. But at least we have Roger, who can do quite a bit of damage then. Then for final stage, swap Rayleigh and Gaban. This gives you their chain boost. Use their special to remove the special bind and get an ore boost. Luffy to get an attack boost. And Black Maria to remove the damage reduction. If you got Nami instead, you're free to use her. Works fine, and it becomes fully boosted then. So this team with Rayleigh Gaban works, and it's not the worst boost, like everything is 1.3 times, so pretty neat. One thing I forgot to note, I think I forgot to change this, I had to remake a bit, but this team doesn't handle the resilience, but it should be doing quite a bit of damage, so it should be fine to use this ship for it. I always pass this ship, it's very annoying. It's like invisible to my eyes. There we go. Dreadnought Saber lets you handle resilience. So yeah, that's our Rayleigh and Gaban team. Now let's go into some Whitey Bay teams. I made quite a few. So let's get down to the second team, and this one uses Roger. Not the best team. As you see, we also have the Dreadnought Saber here, which is obviously not optimal. This team doesn't even have an ore boost, so I doubt it will work the best. You could maybe try and use it if you have the Danger support. This lets you bypass the resilience final stage, even if you use Odin stage 2. In that case, you can use an actual ship and the team becomes a bit better. But for this ship, basically Whitey Bay, Roger super type, Luffy special, and then Roger special on stage 2, and use the rest of the special's final stage. You will see the Kawamatsu support on Shutemura a lot in this video. It lets you remove all of the special bind on only Ashura. So this lets you use Ashura Doji special final stage. This is a Colosseum unit, by the way. So you remove 5 turns special bind, get an attack boost for Slasher and Powerhouse, which is great. So we get an attack boost there. And then Black Maria removes the remaining special bind and also removes the damage reductions. You'll also see Black Maria a lot on this team. And you still have the Call Affinity from Roger and a chain boost from Whitey Bay Special Stage 2. So it should be a decent team that could work if you have that particular support. Moving on, here's another team which doesn't need that support. It's a bit lower points, but you don't need that Luffy either. But you do need a limited free-to-play support, which is not available right now, the Straw Hat Pirates. Works the same as Rayleigh, remove bind, despair, paralysis. It's a really good support. I hope it reruns soon. But basically, this lets you use Brook final stage. And Brook's special lets you do end-of-turn damage, so you handle the resilience using Brook. Otherwise, it works the same as the previous team. Okay, one other team I have here uses Carrot and Wanda Captain. It's pretty good. Carrot and Wanda, if you see here, their Captain ability gives you end-of-turn damage in duo form. Not in solo form, sadly. So for this team to work optimally, you probably need to Limit Break Expand Carrot. This lets you use their level 2 special, stage 2. And then final stage, you can still get the level 1 special. On this team, I start with Carrot in quick form. And then when we get the final stage, I swap Carrot to Dex. And since super swaps are reduced, they should fully charge Carrot and Wanda. Yeah, Slashers is boosted, that's fine. So you get Carrot's attack boost final stage from swap, and you get the ore boost from using their special a second time. And since they're in duo form, you also get the end of turn damage. Which honestly doesn't really matter since we do have Kid and Law here. They will be on most teams because they are perfect for this content. Partly because they have increased damage taken removal for 3 turns. And also because you can use them stage 2. And all their stuff carries over for 3 turns. You get that chain boundary for final stage and stage 2. And you get the increased chain growth as well. As well as the end of turn damage. Which is a bonus on this team since Carrot Wanda handles that anyway. As for stage 2, we're also using this Sabo. Who will give us a death down conditional. And Carousel removes the final turn of paralysis on this team. a treasure map rare recruit. Final stage, we're going to use Hody to remove special bind. This is a bit wonky. You need to have Daruma on level 3. If it's level 4 or if it's level 4 or 5, it procs on stage 2, but we want to save it to stage 3. So very weird. Daruma is available in the medal exchange for 100 medals. If you're desperate to use this team, just so you know, but it needs to be level 3. That way, Hody can remove 5 turns of special bind, and then Black Maria handles the rest. And Black Maria also gives color affinity to Striker and Cerebral, which is most of the deck's units on this team. Sadly, Sabo doesn't get boosted by Whitey Bay, but Carrot Wanda and Hody does, so should be pretty good damage. Carrot Wanda also are able to bypass the barrier, so they will probably do quite a bit of damage. You should probably hit with them relatively early. Like I imagine you should do Black Maria, Sabo, Kid and Law, and then Carrot and Wanda. And then hit with Izo last. Anyway, let's get into the meat of the video. We are going to explore using Sugar as captain here. Sugar is basically perfect for this. The only thing that isn't perfect is that Sugar is driven and cerebral. But if you look at the quest guide, free spirit power out Striker, so Sugar doesn't get any reduction. And the way it works out is that Sugar lacks one measly CD. So we basically need some form of CD reduction to use her special stage 2, which we want really. The problem is that if you look at CD reducers for this treasure map, there's not many at all. Doflamingo is one, but we're not using him to reduce Sugar's CD directly with his special. Instead, having Doffy on the team lets us use Sugar's super type without using her special. So we can use the super type first, get 3 turns of ore boost, and we can then use Sugar's special. I want to note that if your Sugar is level 150 like mine, you also get an attack boost, but if it's below that, you don't get that attack boost. Most teams should work without it. It just makes the teams even better. But yeah, for this team, basically stage 2 Sugar super type, then use some specials before using Sugar special. Like you need to use Kid and Law mainly, and you need to use Whitey Bay to remove the Despair. You don't remove all para with this team, but Sugar does allow you to bypass that. So at least Whitey Bay is guaranteed to hit pretty hard. So I'm hoping that will be enough, even with not that many toys. Then when we get to final stage, yeah, you Sugar and you may just make Kid and Law a toy basically on this particular team and Whitey Bay. Final stage, we use Shutamaru again, get the attack boost, Kawamatsu helps you remove special bind, then we use Black Maria to remove the damage reduction, or color affinity to Kid and Law, I guess, but they aren't boosted by Whitey Bay. Could still do a bit of damage. You can also use the Doflamingo final stage. This will give you a base stat boost to the toys, so basically making Whitey Bay and Kid and Law stronger. And yeah, that's it basically. This is probably the most accessible team you'll find. I think this should work for around 15 nav levels. It's hard to say exactly, I'm basically guesstimating there. But I think this is a pretty decent team. Personally, I just use some form of Ray-Ban team, since it will be easier to find Rayleigh and Gaban frame captains, and they will also do more damage, but if you want White Bay teams, these are some options. I land this video with some other teams. This one in particular was made by my Alliance member, Custer Pink. Shoutouts to him. And yeah, basically this has one of every color, White Bay frame captain. This lets us use the Germa ship, and Germa ship reduces CD for us, which is nice. But yeah, basically the idea with this team is that we use every special stage 2 except for Black Maria. And if you have the Viola support, which you know is popular on this channel, Black Maria can use her special final stage since she removes some extra special buy. So you can use Black Maria final stage only to remove the damage reduction. And then on stage 2, yeah, I just realized that with this team it might be hard to get an attack boost, but I realized that yeah, we can just use cat and dog for that actually. So yeah, we do that to get the attack boost, and then we hit with Roger to get his call affinity for 3 turns, Sugar's super tie for ore boost for 3 turns, Kid and Law for end of turn damage for 3 turns, and Chain Bounder for 3 turns, and increased chain growth rate for 3 turns. And White Bay just removed the spear. Can even swap cat and dog to remove all the paralysis. But remember, if you do use, when you use cat and dog special, don't hit perfect, since then you'll carry over an ore boost, which you don't really want. I guess it doesn't matter, to be honest, since we have the 3 turn of sugar ore boost. That's the problem when you realize stuff in the middle of talking, but yeah, it should be fine. But yeah, this team is very good, you just need that Viola support, but if you have that Viola support, this might be the best team you'll be able to build. Moving on, here's a team with Nami, also uses Sorrow. So basically we use Sorrow on stage 2. Get an ore boost, and basically since we get that ore boost, I guess there's no reason to... yeah, since you have that, we can wait a bit with using Sugar's super type. We can save that for final stage, but we still use Sugar special to make some toys. Basically, we make Sorrow into a toy, and we make Kid and Law into a toy after using their specials, and White Bay, of course, Friend Captain. And yeah, this Nami has a special support. It's a Treasure Map re-recruit Robin, which helps remove special bind final stage. And this lets you use Nami. We have Doflamingo support on Sugar to not do any interrupts. Like, it might not interrupt Nami's special, but I just showcased Doffer there just in case that it might do an interrupt. If it doesn't, it's obviously better to remove it and just use Nami's special. Also removes the damage reduction and resilience, so Nami is really good if you can fit her. And as always, Ashura removing special bind, getting attack boost for him and White Bay mainly. I think I had one final team, right? Yeah. And yeah, basically this team uses the Sabo support. Removes 2 turns of special binds. This lets you use Hody final stage. And yeah, I think it's pretty straightforward. Basically, Kid and Law, Sugar super type, and then use Sugar special to turn Kid and Law and White Bay into toys. Also use White Bay, of course. Then final stage, you use the rest of the specials, and Doff is not needed if Nami isn't interrupted. And you can use Luffy final stage for an attack boost. Sugar handles the ore boost. If you have this Shirahoshi support, you can get color affinity as well. And yeah, that's basically the team. And of course, Nami does the same she did before. But yeah, I think this video is long enough now. I hope you've got some more ideas. I know this particular content is very annoying, but it has to be done. And here you have some more teams for it. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.